Simply Mechanisms, one in a series of videos that I prepared on organic mechanisms. Here I take a look at ozone formation and depletion in the stratosphere, a process that involves both oxygen and chlorine radicals. Now let's take a look at what happens in the oxygen molecule. I've simplified the double bond here, I'm only showing two of the four electrons of the oxygen's double bond. But as a result of the effects of UV radiation in the stratosphere, we get the splitting of oxygen molecules into what are called radicals. This is a fishhook arrow and it tracks the movement of one electron. So we have two fishhook arrows indicating that one electron goes to the left oxygen atom and the other to the right oxygen atom. So they split as shown. This would indicate the formation of radicals. At the bottom there you can see a radical is defined as a species with an unpaired electron. It's also known as homolytic fission. When the molecules split, both atoms were treated equally. We can summarize it more simply by taking the O2 molecule and show it being split into two oxygen radicals. And this is often how it's shown. However, I'd like to demonstrate that in fact oxygen radicals have not one but two unpaired electrons. So let's look at this in better detail at the top here. That's my oxygen molecule then. And you can see in the middle between the two oxygen atoms they are sharing two pairs of electrons. When the oxygen molecule splits, this is essentially what's happening. We're ending up with two oxygen atoms with six valence electrons. Up at the top here we'll build up the electronic configuration. Let's see where these eight electrons go. Two into the 1s level and the other six go into the second energy level. And if you look at 2s and 2p, you'll see there that we have two lone pairs and two unpaired electrons. So the oxygen atom or oxygen radical actually has two unpaired electrons. So you can show it either with one dot or better still with two dots to represent the two unpaired electrons. Now this is how ozone is formed in the stratosphere. An oxygen molecule will hit one of those radicals and that forms our ozone molecule. And ozone shields us against the damaging UVB radiation which causes skin cancer amongst other things. At the bottom here I'd like to show you how the electrons are assigned in the ozone molecule. So I'm bringing in my oxygen molecule together with my oxygen radical and reassigning the electrons there. In that ozone molecule you can probably make out there with the electrons being shared that we have a double bond between the middle oxygen and the one to the left and a single bond between the oxygen and the one to the right. Now I've put a minus value, minus sign on that oxygen to the right because it effectively has seven electrons. It's got its six blue spheres which represent its six original electrons, but it's also gained a share in that pair of electrons represented by the two crosses. A share in a pair means you're up an electron and therefore it has a negative charge. Meanwhile the oxygen in the middle, if we count the number of electrons it has, it's got one lone pair, plus it has the share in three pairs. A share in three pairs adds up to three, so three and two is five. It's down an electron effectively, and that's why it's shown with a positive charge. So that's been my look at ozone formation. Now let's look at ozone depletion, caused in particular by molecules like this called CFCs, chlorofluorocarbons. This particular one is dichlorodifluoromethane. These enter the stratosphere about 10 miles high up from their usage on Earth. In the past they would have been used as propellants in aerosols and as refrigerants in fridges. You see our UV rays coming through here again, and as they did with the oxygen molecule originally there at the top left, they have a tendency to break the CCl bond. They happen to have an energy that comes into resonance with the vibration of the CCl bond, causing some of these molecules to split as you see there, producing two radicals, and in particular that chlorine radical. So let me bring over an ozone molecule now, O3, and see how that chlorine radical begins a cycle of destruction. There's my chlorine radical. Again, a radical is a species with an unpaired electron. And let's see what it does. It collides with the ozone molecule and causes the ozone molecule to split, to produce a molecule of oxygen O2 together with this radical ClO. And let's see what the ClO radical does next. The important thing is that that step has broken down one molecule of ozone into oxygen, but it's also created this destructive radical, as you'll see, because this ClO radical also, when it collides with an ozone molecule, causes it to split. Let's see what the products of this are. So here we get two molecules of oxygen, and what else? Well, perhaps you can reason there that we're getting, in addition to the oxygen, we get our chlorine radical back again, our chlorine atom or chlorine radical. So as the chlorine radical is being regenerated, you can see that the chlorine radical is actually behaving as a catalyst. And that does mean then that we'll get into a cycle of this happening. And just one chlorine radical produced from a CFC will go on and on and on, breaking down ozone molecules as a result of these two steps, which are propagation steps, as we have a radical on both sides. And it's the southern hemisphere that suffers most from ozone depletion, because the polar vortex at the Antarctic traps ozone depleted air during the spring and then later releases it to neighbouring countries such as Australia, New Zealand, Argentina and Chile. And we can't afford to be complacent in the northern hemisphere either, because there are signs that it's having an increasing effect at the North Pole as well. So that's been my look at the mechanism behind ozone formation and depletion in the stratosphere. Do please consider looking at others in this series entitled Simply Mechanisms. Thanks for listening.